Hi guys, hyperLativ here, the Norwegian gamer, and this is some gameplay from Bad Company 2, where I'm playing some squad deathmatch. And in the background, you can hear me talking to a lady friend of mine, so if you're wondering what those voices are, it's me and my friend talking. So, what I wanted to talk to you about is not something game-related. For once, perhaps. As you might or may not know, I'm really a technology enthusiast and really pay attention to the technology industry, or media at least, in the technology world. And I'm a nerd, so it's what I'm interested in generally. So you might or might have not heard that Nokia is actually adopting Windows Phone 7 for some of their phones, or more or less all their phones, I believe. And they preferred, obviously, Windows Phone 7 over Android, because they're now dropping the support, or dropping the heavy use of Symbian, which has been their operating system for their phones so far. They've developed Symbian on their own and used it on their phones more or less exclusively. Actually, the Sony Ericsson's operating system is also based on Symbian, but it's their own build of Symbian. Sony Ericsson has used they've built upon Symbian, to put it that way, much the same way that a lot of phone manufacturers do with Android. So now they're adopting Windows Phone 7 instead, and because of the special deal with Microsoft, the CEO, I believe, of Nokia now is actually a former Microsoft employee, and because of that special connection, Nokia has made a deal with Microsoft, allowing them to be the only phone manufacturer that is actually allowed to change the design or edit the design of Windows Phone 7. So for all the other manufacturers, you have to follow special criterias for the phone, like what specs it can have, what kind of processor it can have, what screen size it can have, what kind of resolution the screen can have, and stuff like that. But Nokia has made a deal where they actually can change the hardware of the phone and still have Windows Phone 7 run on it, and they can actually change the I'm not sure if they can change the interface of Windows Phone 7 per se, but at least they can change it up. I'm not really sure on the details. And for me, who is a believer in Windows Phone 7, it really it's disheartening, you know, because the iPhone is a great device, I'm not denying that, and iOS is a great operating system, I'm not denying that. It had some lack of features when it first came out, but from version 3.0 and the 3GS, I believe it's on par, and I believe it's a good phone. And the iPhone 4 is a great phone. I mean, it's excellent hardware, it's excellent software. I mean, it's really good. And yes, the iPhone 4 may not be the best phone in the world, but for a handheld computer, it's awesome. And personally, I don't use the phone as much as a phone anymore, but more a handheld computer. So for me, the iPhone 4 is great, and I own an iPhone 4. So, and I owned an iPhone 3GS too, but and I'm happy with those phones by all means. But I'm on the lookout for a new phone, because I feel iPhone is starting to become more and more closed, and Apple is restricting it more and more. And I find that I kind of want to try something new. And this is something I do on a regular basis, more or less. Before I got the iPhone, I was an Android nut. I used an Android phone. I was, you know, evangelizing Android because I thought it was an awesome operating system. And I thought it was a good, with some competition regarding iOS. And the problem with Android was, or still kind of is because is the wide difference in devices and the big, how should I put it, the big diversity and a fraction of the platform. There's so many different screen sizes. There's so many different versions of the operating system running. There's so many different camera resolutions, cameras. Does the phone have front-facing camera or not? There's so many different. Look at that. It, there came blood, but I didn't kill it. What's that all about? There's all kinds of different screen sizes. I may have said that, and resolutions, and all this is very confusing and very, very. It's a very big drawback, especially to the to developers, which have to make application that can handle all these different screen resolutions, or even if they want to support all those screen resolutions, and just drop some of the devices, which then makes a bad experience for the users. So I was really frustrated with Google allowing this to happen, and so when Windows Phone 7 came along with a new interface that actually looked new and just wasn't a ripoff of the iOS user interface, and with a philosophy of very strict hardware specs, which made the phones feel phone experience more consistent, both for users and for developers, but still allowing manufacturers to kind of get their own personal touch of the phone, the hardware, that is, not the software of course, but just being allowed to do that. And I thought, this is great, this is just what I wanted Android to be, and it's even a new interface, which is actually quite different from what we already have. So now I hear that Nokia is allowed to change the user interface, and this just puts the whole thing, I mean, this ruins everything, because yes, it may be only be Nokia, and I hope that it's not a trend that they're going to extend to other manufacturers over time, but the problem is that if all the Nokia phones are going to have, say, different screen resolutions, which the new Nokia Windows Phone 7 phone actually do. It has a different screen resolution. It actually has the size of the screen is different in its dimensions, so that you'll end up with a phone that won't support all the applications that have already been written. They won't support that screen size properly because of it's new, and that ruins the whole point. And here's the end of the video too. I hope to see you next time. Snackis.